now, the Bible could have been watered down.
Like that's what he just no. He left for it.
He said it almost tampered.
Well, here's the thing. Here's the thing.
But I'm saying watered down.
I'm trying to say.
What I'll say is because there's a lot of Masonic symbolism in the Bible, like 66, 33.
Like the what?
66, 33. You know, 33 is Christ endowed. Christ endowed at age 33.
That's, how do you know?
That's a Masonic number.
So because of the Masons.
The
numbers? No. No, I want to say what you're
saying. It's like saying, okay, they're saying, well, Christ was born on Christmas. Ain't wrong. He was born somewhere in
springtime.
In the springtime.
Yeah. That's what
he was born in the winter
solstice.
Solstice.
You know?
Yeah, plus I also too believe that a lot of the books are missing out of the Bible.
Well, what books? There are some books missing, but like for example, the Apocrypha.
They left us with this.
No, but you haven't even mastered this.
The Maccabees,
first and second Maccabees is in the Apocrypha.
There's a lot of books.
But my point is, but a lot of brothers they turn their back on the Bible because they say books are missing, but they haven't even mastered this. They haven't even cleaned themselves up with the basic Bible. You understand? And do you think the Creator would just leave us in just chaos with nothing to read? Just say, all right, just throw everything out. It's books are missing. The Creator ain't going to leave us like that. As far as number 33, you can't say the Bible is Masonic.
Well, a lot of witches
use the Bible. But that don't mean in slavery, they use the Bible to enslave black people.
Yeah. They use Christmas and put Christmas in the
church. No, Christmas is Christmas. Like, Christmas is not in the Bible. Christ wasn't born.
They put Christmas in the churches and put all the pagan holidays.
Okay, well, then if you read the Bible, you would come out of that.
That's basically subliminal messaging.
It's mind control.
My question is more of, would it have been possible that by the time from when it was written to when we got our words today, here now, would it be possible that it was?
I don't. You know what?
From watered down.
No. I don't.
I believe this.
Okay.
I believe this.
I don't believe that because I don't think the Most High would just leave us high and dry like that. Do you believe in God?
Used to.
See, whereas I believe in God, I don't believe that God would leave us high and dry like that. A lot of people take. Give me Proverbs 30 verse 5. A lot of people take that approach because they don't want to follow the Bible, and a lot of people who have been deceived and have taken that approach, 30 and 5. A lot of people have taken that approach, they just walking around in limbo. I don't believe that. I see a lot of things that's happening on earth today that relates to the prophecies in the Bible today. So for me to believe in a Creator, a powerful Creator, I don't think he would leave people he loved just in limbo like that. That means if that was the case, there's no truth. Just walk around, do what you want to do. You have to have structure and order, and the Bible is structure and order. Let me just read something for you real quick, and then you can ask your next question, or he can respond, or somebody else can ask him the question.
Yeah, I believe in read
that.
Proverbs chapter 30, verse 5.
Check this out.
Every word of God is pure.
Read it again for him.
Every word of God is pure.
Every word of God is pure. Come on.
He's a shield unto them that put their trust in him.
See, now that's my shield. That's my protection, man. You know, if I didn't follow the Bible, I'd be smoking weed, chasing women, robbing, stealing maybe. I'd be doing all kind of crazy things. But the Lord said the Bible is the shield, or the word of God is a shield to them that put their trust in him. So I don't think the Creator is just going to leave us out here just high and dry like that. And again, the prophecies are coming to pass. The Bible is the most read book on this planet. Right. Even though the devil, the white man, when he makes his movies, what book does he use? He uses the King James Bible. When you go watch The Omen, he got quotes out of the King James Bible. Why don't they use the Jehovah's Witness Bible or the Quran? They always go to the Bible. You mentioned the Masons. Even the Masons, they offer, they try to claim parts of the Bible.
I'm using the crisis actors.
What you say, Lamar?
Brother, let me ask you a question, right? Let's use common sense for a second. When they read history, right?
Yeah.
Now, how do the white men know about the Dead Sea?
He doesn't.
You sure? How do white men know about the Dead Sea? You know about heard about the Dead Sea,
just keep
right?
Just keep
what information, what book you get that from?
It's the Dead Sea.
The Dead Sea.
Dead Sea is a mass of water in
In ancient Egypt, right?
That nothing can live in because it's so small for your soul.
Now, when you read any history book,
It never mentioned the Dead Sea away from what? From the Bible. The Red Sea and so forth. All those things. Now, when you talk about Egyptian, the chariot, the pharaohs, right? What book spoke about the pharaohs before the Bible? No other book. How do white men know these things? Do you know when the white men read the Bible, the white men definitely went to the Dead Sea and found the chariot in the sea that the Bible mentioned? No other book talks about that. The white men went up to the different mountain that Abraham spoke about, Mesopotamia, where the Bible speaks about Mesopotamia, known today as modern-day Iraq, and found cities like City of Ur of the Chaldees. We get it from the Bible. There's no other record tells us that. We already know people is going to say, well, the Bible is tampered with. Now, when you talk about the King James Bible, the King James Bible is the most accurate book, brother. All you got to do, like the hell I said, do your research. You'll find out the Bible is accurate. Now, let me ask you a question, right? Let me ask you a question. How did black men come to America? What did the black men came to America?
Slaves.
A slave, right? Where did they came? They came on an airplane or a ship?
Ships.
Now, do you know it's in the Bible? It's in the Bible, brother. No,
says,
no, you say no.
Says,
but we're just using an example to show you the Bible is not tampered with.
No, brother.
Everything in the Bible said is come to pass.
You said something in the Bible that
we're going to come to into another Egypt with ship.
Can I ask you to read that to me?
Okay, sure, no problem. And because remember, when Moses brought the Jews on Mount Sinai, we're talking about the Jews, we're talking about the black Hispanic, okay? The Jews are these people
the Arawaks, the Indians, the Israelites on Mount Sinai, right? This is a government confirms this is Noah's Ark. They found Noah's Ark. How do you explain that? There's a lot of different books and proof about Noah's Ark. It says the Bible says Noah's Ark landed on Mount Ararat, Genesis 8 and 4, which is a modern-day esteemed Turkey. In 1977, Rayon Wyatt discovered the remains after several archaeological investigations. It was discovered this same measurement given by the Bible, and it was recognized and adopted by the government of Turkey as the remains of Noah's Ark. And it's like, see, article right there, Noah's Ark. Understand? And that's not the only thing they got, you know, this. It's, all you gotta do is research. There's all kinds of things that back up the Bible.
Get to Deuteronomy chapter 28:6 here. The Bible tells when Moses brought the Jews on Mount Sinai, which are these people, the black and Hispanic, those are the Jews. The white men know that. Columbus knows that. Columbus will give him more information than us. Because Columbus, if Columbus was supposed to come back in America today and ask God for forgiveness, which is not going to happen, and ask who are the real Jews, Columbus would say the Jews are the black and Hispanic. They're not going to call you, he's not going to say black or Hispanic. He's going to call you the children of Israel. Because Columbus know these people that he was be acquainted with, they were known as Israelites. That's why he tell them Columbus have Jews and a slave ship as what? As Hebrew interpreter, because the people that he's going to be acquainted with spoke Hebrew. Okay? So now, the brother going to read Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 16. Okay? So remember, when Moses brought the Jews on Mount Sinai, Moses said, oh, we're going to go back into another Egypt again with ships. Let's see what Egypt Moses was speaking about. Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 16.
It says, and the Lord shall bring me into Egypt again with ships.
Again being the second time with ships. The first time we went to Egypt, what time period was doing that? When the Hyksos was ruling Egypt. When Joseph was Joseph position again?
Joseph was on second in command.
Second in commandment under the pharaohs. Joseph invited the Israelites. They went into Egypt with ship. They walked into Egypt because there was a famine in the land of Canaan. At that time, the Canaanite, the South African, was ruling Egypt at that time. So the Israelites went into Egypt and walked down there. Okay, because the Ixar was ruling at that time period. They did not take no ship. You don't need a ship from Israel to Egypt. All you gotta do is walk it. What Egypt the Bible was speaking to? What about America? How do we know that? We got proof to cut you off.
And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again with ship.
With ship. You know what the ship was called? It was called the Good Ship of Jesus. If you ask Isabella Fernandez II if they was alive today, what people went into slave ship? The Moors. The Moors were Jews that ruled Spain till 1453. 1453. They put them on slave ship and brought them here. The ship was called the Good Ship of Jesus because we're prophesying the Bible that we will come to America in cargo slave ship. Then in West Virginia, you got Israel coming from North Africa, South Africa, all over the place in Africa as slave. Because why? Because they prophesy in the Bible that we're going to come to modern day Egypt and America as cargo slave ship. All you got to do, look at your $1 bill. You got the pyramids, right? What does the pyramid symbolize? That America is a new Egypt. How do we know America is a new Egypt also? When we finish, we're going to show you another chapter. Read.
And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again with ships.
With ship, with slave ship. It was called the Good Ship of Jesus. Go ahead.
By the way, I spake unto thee.
Which is on Mount Ararat. Go ahead.
Thou shalt see it no more again.
In other words, you're not going to see your land Jerusalem. Okay? When the last, we ask the black and Hispanic, where your homeland? Well, my land is Puerto Rico, Dominican, whatever land they come from, that's their land. But your homeland is Jerusalem. How did black and so-called northern kingdom from away from this kingdom, you got Judah, Benjamin, Levi. All these tribes from down there, all the way down to the Mexican, they came to America in 722 BC. Okay? Like we said, you ask Nostradamus, Montezuma. Montezuma said his forefather came from ancient Israel. How did Montezuma know that? Because Montezuma know his forefather. Montezuma was in ignorance. You have to ask a black and Hispanic, what's your homeland? I'm African American. My homeland is Africa. Black man's land is not Africa. His homeland is Jerusalem. Okay? So these three, the 10 tribes, under the 10 tribes, where the leader was known to us who? The Puerto Ricans. That's why Puerto Rican and black American hang together. Because why? It's going back to the northern kingdom and the southern kingdom, Jeroboam, Rehoboam. Okay? So the three tribes, Judah, Benjamin, Levi, these tribes were during the time of Christ. And Christ tell you, I'm a sheep that are not on the flow. I will go and teach them. Their record proving that Christ come to America and taught the American Indians.
Let me say something real quick. Yeah. Like you said, like you had Judah, Benjamin, and Levi. This is known right. as the southern kingdom. But then you had the Puerto Ricans that controlled the northern kingdom.
Right.
Now you got many immigrants that come to this country. You got Koreans, mm-hmm. Chinese, right. Japanese. Why is it that the Puerto Ricans always end up in the ghettos with the so-called blacks? Why is it the Dominicans always end up in the ghetto with the blacks? Why is it the Mexicans always end up in the ghettos with the blacks? Because it's a spiritual thing and we're all one nation.
And we're both catching the same hell.
There you go.
Prove to the Bible too. Because they got, slack up, I'm gonna make it come. They got this Mexican guy, right? Him and his wife went to Mexico. That's 5 months ago. And the moment they went to Mexico, when they came back, their house burnt down. They didn't leave on the door. We don't want no niggas in our neighborhood. That happened in Long Island. How the white, if Hispanic called themselves white, why the white man don't want you among them? Why the white man call you Afro-Latino? Because you know you're not white. You're the same people. It's just that you just have a lighter complexion. Your ears sounded different. No difference. You see what I'm saying? So these 10 tribes right here, these tribes have a hate for this Judah, Benjamin, Levi. That's why when you saw him married up a Dominican or Mexican or Puerto Rican, they were like, no papi, no good. But when the white man step up the slave master, yes, no problem. Because when you read the Bible, this tribe, northern kingdom, have a hate to the southern kingdom. When you read the Bible, because Samuel tells you why the northern kingdom didn't like the southern kingdom. Because what happened, the southern kingdom went to war against Moab. And the northern kingdom, Ephraim, were like, listen, why didn't you call us to fight war for you so we could get the credit? So the Judah were like, nah, we don't want nothing to do with you, man. So that's how the three tribes break off. So while it was in captivity under the Syrian, the text council among themselves, I said, you know what, we're going to leave the Assyrian and come to America, another land that was known as Assyrians. Okay? That's how the Puerto Rican, the Dominican, and the American Indian end up in America.
When you study history, Columbus, it's said that Columbus read a part of the Bible called the Apocrypha. Mm-hmm. And the Apocrypha prophesied that you was going to have other 12 tribes that's going to come to the Americas. It's in history.
Right.
But my question is, why, when you look at this sign, why does the white man accept the Koreans here in their neighborhoods or among
right.
them,
right.
but reject you Puerto Ricans, seeing you right here with us?
Right.
They're from another land. Why are all these foreigners come to this country and are not rejected, but your people are rejected, or your tribe, or the Hispanics are rejected except among the so-called Negroes? That's a spiritual thing.
But you got something to say, brother?
How is it that we get to heaven?
How do we got to get to heaven?
Yeah.
First of all, that's a question, brother. That's a Christian doctrine.